Holy Mass this morning is offered for Nichelle A. Thorne. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. Gladden us with holy joys, Almighty God, and make us rejoice with devout thanksgiving. For the ascension of Christ your Son is our exaltation, and where the head has gone before in glory, the body is called to follow in hope. Through our Lord Jesus Christ your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In the first book, Theophilus, I dealt with all that Jesus did and taught until the day he was taken up, after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. He presented himself alive to them by many proofs after he had suffered, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While meeting with them, he enjoined them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father about which you have heard me speak. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. When they had gathered together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? He answered them, It is not for you to know the times or the seasons that the Father has established by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were looking on, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him from their sight. While they were looking intently at the sky as he was going, suddenly, two men dressed in white garments stood beside them. They said, Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking at the sky? This Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will return in the same way as you have seen him going into heaven. The word of the Lord. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, may the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation, resulting in knowledge of him. May the eyes of your hearts be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to his call. What are the riches of glory in his inheritance among the holy ones? And what is the surpassing greatness of his power for us who believe in accord with the exercise of his great might, which he worked in Christ, raising him from the dead and seating him at his right hand in the heavens, far above every principality, authority, power, and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And he put all things beneath his feet and gave him as head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of the one who fills all things in every way. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said to his disciples, "Thus it is written that the Christ will suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins will be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things. And behold, I am sending the promise of my Father upon you. But stay in the city until you are clothed with power from on high." Then he led them out as far as Bethany, raised his hands and blessed them. And he blessed them, he parted from them and was taken up to heaven. They did him homage and then returned to Jerusalem with great joy. And they were continually in the temple praising God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Blessed feast day. What a great mystery we celebrate as we proclaim the ascension of Jesus into heaven. I love the line in the Acts of the Apostles when the angel speaks to the apostles as Jesus ascends into heaven. And I can picture the scene that Jesus is ascending into heaven and they're standing looking up and wondering what's going on. And the angels come and say, "Hey guys, get your head out of the clouds. Get your head out of the clouds. Didn't you hear what Jesus told you? He told you, get back to Jerusalem, get back on your knees and start praying. Pray for that gift of the Holy Spirit. Pray with all your heart and open yourselves up to this next mystery which is about to unfold. The ascension of Jesus isn't the end of the story, but it really moves now to the next chapter. And that next chapter is going to be the coming of the Holy Spirit upon them that they are then sent out as witnesses. You will be my witnesses. You will receive power when you receive the Holy Spirit, and you will be my witnesses right here in Jerusalem, all around Judea, even in Samaria, even to the ends of the earth." So yeah, the angels tell them, "Why are you standing here with you, looking up into the skies? Get your head out of the clouds and get busy." Paul speaks to the Ephesians and prays that the eyes of our hearts might be opened. We pray today on this solemn feast of the Ascension that the eyes of our hearts may be opened so that we might look more deeply into reality, so that we might look more deeply at this great mystery of the ascension of Jesus Christ, which ultimately means that Jesus, who rose from the dead, is now with us in new ways. That Jesus is with us always. That he's with us here and when we go somewhere else during the day, not just in one place, in one moment, but that Jesus is with us always. We pray that the eyes of our hearts may be open, that we may see the presence of the risen Christ working within us through the power of his Holy Spirit. But we pray that the eyes of our hearts may be opened, that we may recognize his call to be his witnesses. Indeed, the book is not closed. This generation, we come along now as the next chapter in this story. God's great work of redemption, of love. Jesus is risen indeed. He is present in this world today, in 2022. And let's face it, the world today needs that witness of Jesus risen more than ever. Our hearts are broken as we mourn with those who mourn in Texas, in Buffalo, and even on smaller but regular levels in many cities across our nation. Witnesses of Jesus Christ bring consolation and solidarity, show tremendous care for one another, stand together and heal, and constantly look, not just in emotional ways at the moment, but constantly look for solutions and for approaches to bring about an end of violence. For it's so multifaceted. On this feast of the Ascension, we hear the call of Jesus, sending us as his witnesses that he is alive and he continues to minister among us, and we hear his voice. We ask that the eyes of our hearts may be opened, that we may open the eyes of the hearts of the world. On this solemn feast day, the Church invites us to renew our profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us turn to the Lord with our hopes and our needs.
For all the members of the Church, may the Holy Spirit inspire us as authentic living witnesses to Jesus Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For civic leaders and all who are in positions of authority, may God empower them to speak the truth in love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, may they experience God's healing and peace through His grace and the loving care of others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those gathered here, may the Lord renew and deepen our faith and lead us to greater joy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially the young people in Texas, Buffalo, and Ukraine, may they, through the mercy of God, rest in peace in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. For Nichelle A. Thorne, whom this Mass has offered, for all of our own particular intentions and those who have asked our prayers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
God of love and mercy, be close to us always. Console our hearts that are broken and help us to be instruments of your peace through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
May be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. We offer sacrifice now in supplication, O Lord, to honor the wondrous ascension of your Son. Grant, we pray, that through this most holy exchange, we too may rise up to the heavenly realms through Christ our Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the Lord Jesus, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended today in the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder. Mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, he ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head, has gone before us. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy. Every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and me, your unworthy servant, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise. Well, they offer it for themselves and for those who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in the hope of health and well-being, paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating that most sacred day on which your only begotten Son, our Lord, placed at the right hand of your glory our weak human nature, which he had united to himself, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, the Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all the saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands. With eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. And once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gift you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the holy offering of your high priest Melchizedek, the holy sacrifice, the spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us, through this participation at the altar, receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
You take
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only
say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who allow those on earth to celebrate divine mysteries, grant, we pray, that Christian hope may draw us onward to where our nature is united with you, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
Bow down for the blessing.
May Almighty God bless you, for on this very day his only begotten Son pierced the heights of heaven and unlocked for you the way to ascend to where he is. Amen.
Amen.
May he grant that as Christ after his resurrection was seen plainly by his disciples, so when he comes as judge, he may show himself mercifully to you for all eternity. Amen. And may you who believe that he is seated with the Father in his majesty know the joy and the fulfillment of his promise to stay with you until the end of time. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Go forth, our Mass has ended.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who roam about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
our litany for vocations. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
God, the Father of heaven,
have mercy on us.
God, the Son, Redeemer of the world,
have mercy on us.
God, the Holy Spirit,
have mercy on us.
Holy Trinity, one God,
have mercy on us.
Holy Mary,
pray for us.
Holy Mother of God,
pray for us.
Holy Virgin of Virgins,
pray for us.
Saint Michael, leader of the heavenly host,
pray for us.
Saint Gabriel, messenger of God's divine plan,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael, companion of the journey,
pray for us.
All you holy angels and archangels,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph, protector of the Holy Church,
pray for us.
Saint John Vianney, patron of parish priests,
pray for us.
Saint Aloysius Gonzaga, patron of youth,
pray for us.
Saint Alphonsus Liguori, patron of vocations,
pray for us.
Saint Charles Borromeo, patron of seminarians,
pray for us.
Saint John Berkmans, patron of altar servers,
pray for us.
Saint Maria Goretti, patron of teenagers,
pray for us.
All you holy men and women,
pray for us.
Be merciful,
spare us, O Lord.
Be merciful.
Graciously hear us, O Lord.
through your mercy,
send workers into your harvest, O Lord.
Through your kindness,
spare us, O Lord.
Through the fervent prayers and sacrifices of your people,
send workers into your harvest, O Lord.
Through the power of the holy sacrifice of the Mass,
send workers into your harvest, O Lord.
Through the intercession of all the saints and angels,
send workers into your harvest, O Lord.
Through the sanctification of the family,
send workers into your harvest, O Lord.
Through parents being generously open to life,
send workers into your harvest, O Lord.
Through the example of priests and religious striving for holiness,
send workers into your harvest, O Lord.
Through a renewed sense of fidelity to our Catholic faith,
send workers into your harvest, O Lord.
That young people might seek to live the truth of Christ,
Lord of our hearts, graciously hear us.
That young people might seek God's will for them in their lives,
Lord of our hearts, graciously hear us.
That young people might hear the call to give their lives for the mission of the Church.
Lord of our hearts, graciously hear us.
That all priests and religious might be renewed in the spirit of the new evangelization.
Lord of our hearts, graciously hear us.
That bishops might be strengthened to be courageous shepherds.
Lord of our hearts, graciously hear us.
That we may always zealously pray for and promote vocations.
Lord of our hearts, graciously hear us.
That those who are being called to be priests and religious might respond generously.
Lord of our hearts, graciously hear us.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
spare us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
graciously hear us, O
Lord. Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
The harvest is great, but the laborers are few.
We beg the harvest master to send out laborers for his harvest.
Let us pray. O God, who chose the apostles to make disciples of all nations, and who by baptism and confirmation has called us to build up your holy church, we implore you to choose among us, your children, many priests and religious who will love you with their whole heart and will gladly spend their entire lives making you known and loved by all. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.